It's been a while since I've reviewed Pomelo on the channel, and when I did that, it was for a compilation video. So I think my review of the Pomelo is old and it's kind of hard to find. So probably a good time to do a reminder of what the Pomelo tastes like. And as I film this, it is around Chinese New Year. So the Asian supermarket that I got this from had like 5 or 6 different Pomelos for sale of different levels of, I'm guessing, quality, not necessarily that there are any major differences between them. They had some that were white flesh pomelos and some that were red flesh pomelos, and I think this is a red pomelo or pink pomelo when you cut it open. This guy was $9. One thing I'm going to try to do though is open it properly. When I did this last time, I just like hacked into it like a caveman. There is a special way that you're supposed to open a pomelo, so let's see if I can do it. So according to the instructions that came with this pomelo, you're supposed to tip it on its side, lop off the top, like so, probably a little deeper than that. Yeah. And then you score it, like this. And then you tear down the sides. Like so. Oh. This is a good one. Wow, I can see why this one was more expensive. You know, in the past, when I reviewed a pomelo, the rind on it was very, very thick, and the fruit inside was just like the size of like a grapefruit. This thing is huge. Yeah, that's pretty impressive. Okay. Alright, kind of looks like this has tentacles. Won't lie, but still, sure it's going to be delicious. Yeah, and the thing with pomelo is that the bits of pulp in there are huge. Very, very big. It's like if you took a grapefruit and you just like enlarged everything about it. The rind, the pith, the membrane, and the pulp, it's all bigger. Yeah, all that pulp is huge, and also it's very dry, so this like breaks apart like that. This would actually be pretty good to like break this up and like put it in a drink. It's like almost like a natural like bubble tea. It's getting all these little bits of pulp in there that are fairly large. Pomelo, by the way, is one of the ancestral species of citrus. So if you take any citrus fruit and you look at the parentage of it, like what two trees had to come together to create that little fruit baby, and you trace it all the way back to the grandparents of the grandparents of the grandparents, you will eventually come to an ancestral species, one that does not have parentage beyond it. And pomelo is one of those. So, for instance, if you were to hybridize a pomelo with a mandarin, you get an orange. And then if you take an orange and you cross that with another citrus, you get another citrus. And it goes like that.
Yeah, these things are really cool because it looks like an orange wedge, but just like so much bigger. Like everything is proportional, but just bigger.
It's like a dinosaur version of a citrus.
Okay, so I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna crack into it to get that pulp out, like so. Because I believe this membrane is going to be pretty tough. I'm not going to want to eat that. Hmm.
Pomelos are really good. It's like a grapefruit, but more mild. There's less bitterness to it. That is like the key thing. You get maybe a touch of bitterness, but not a lot. The sweetness is good. It's around the sweetness of, I'd say the sweetness of an orange, maybe a little bit more. The tartness that's there is pretty low, but there's a little bit. I'd say it's like a 3 out of 10, a little less than an orange.
But these are really nice. The flavor on it is mild, but it's kind of addictive. Like, as big as it is, I could probably eat the whole thing. It's not a strong flavor, but it's a really good one. And it's very refreshing. The texture on it is wild, because you're getting all those little bits, and it's like kind of dry. Biting into the pulp has a texture that's maybe a little bit like a finger lime, where each individual piece of pulp has a little pop to it, like caviar. You know, it's nice. It's something I think you could actually take that and break them apart and put them on a dessert or something to add a little bit of texture and flavor to like a piece of cheesecake or something. That would be good. And the pomelo is just so interesting in that it is a part of so many different citruses that we eat. I don't have the white variety, I just have the pink variety. But one flavor that I can kind of pick up like faintly inside this that I don't think is in the white variety is a touch of like pomegranate, like a slight berry flavor. So I wonder if maybe what is giving this a little bit of a blush color is also in pomegranates or berries or something, because I'm getting like a little touch of that sort of flavor in there. So yeah, I think this is a good one to revisit, especially now that I'm reviewing so many citrus fruits. It's important to know where those fruits come from. And this is something that is not that hard to find. If you have a well-stocked supermarket, you'll probably see one of these at some point. If you have an Asian supermarket, you might find a few varieties of it. And it is definitely worth picking up. They can be expensive, but it's not that bad. It's one that's worth splurging on. I can see why these are so popular for celebratory times. Like Chinese New Year, getting one of these, it feels special to have this, and it is. So I think that's it, guys. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye. I would like to give a shout out to Smarter Every Day, AltPod, and the Harbor Leaf Tea Company. They are mega patrons over on Patreon.com. If you haven't heard of it, Patreon.com is how this channel happens. It's how I can afford to keep this YouTube channel going. So if you haven't checked it out, please take a moment to go into the description below and click the link there. I also have t-shirts for sale over at my web store. A link to that is in the description as well. Thanks so much, guys. Bye-bye.